Violet was there, and I think we lost her. Oh, there she is.
I'm still here.
Hey, Saya. Hi, everybody.
Violet's your paper. Super excited.
I have all of my.
Violet's excited. Is that what you said?
Yes, I'll show you Violet's whole setup here. She's at her art table in her bedroom with every art supply she owns out.
Well, most of them.
I love it.
She's so excited.
Oh, she should be. I am too. I'm really looking forward to this one. And then we can get her dad on hopefully soon too.
I like that.
Yeah. He's downstairs doing work.
Hi, Chloe G. Here. All right, let me just answer a question real quick here.
Can you see her okay, Mr. Deaver?
What's that?
Can you see her okay? Because I know a lot of times she's in the dark.
I can see mostly her silhouette. I mean, I can see her. It's the window that makes it difficult.
Is that better or worse?
Hold on 1 second.
I'm gonna just draw while I'm waiting.
All right, yes, that's way better. Nice job. Love
okay,
it.
Perfect.
We can see you.
Finally.
Although I can't see the Miss Pac-Man, so I'm disappointed. I'm kidding. It's all right. I don't need to see Miss Pac-Man. Oh, there she is. All right, good. Aiden, hi. How are you? You doing good? All right, man. I like your Marvel t-shirt. That's cool. Very nice. Glad you could join us. Hi, Sophia. Hi, Saya. Hey, Saya. I posted all those questions that from you guys on the Mystery Science Facebook page, and a ton of people loved your question.
You think?
And they liked Nolan's question too. So yeah, nice job both. I mean, everybody did a good job, but you got a lot of response on that. Let's see, what else can we play here?
Oh, can you play the Lola song? That'd be funny.
Play the what?
Lola Showgirl song.
All right, let's see if I can find it. Let's see here. Oops. And hello. All right, let's see here. Here we go. Oh, wait, that's not, I mean, it is it, but it's not what I was looking for. Hold on. Da-da-da. Let's see here. Let me do a little search here. Oh, here we go. Is that right? Yep. Hey, Hayden. Hi, Hayden. Brodo, hello. Welcome back.
Her name was Lola. She was a showgirl with yellow feathers in her hair and a dress cut down her leg. She would meringue.
Hi, Amanda. Sophia, you reached. Sophia, you raised your hand.
That was an accident.
What's that?
It was an accident.
Oh, okay. Hi, Carter. Hey, Rob.
I'm an elephant. This reminds me of Aladdin.
Aladdin. Yeah, a little bit, huh? That's true.
His name was Rico.
Rico. You were a diamond.
He was escorted to his
That should be our 10-minute quick write. His name was Rico. He wore a diamond. Go. Aiden, go ahead and mute yourself, okay? Everybody's got paper, right? I saw Aiden just got some paper. Hey, Milesh, glad you can join us. Hi, Alice. Hi, Connor's mom. Hi, Violet's sister, I think. Waiting for a few more people. Hopefully more will show up. How about a little Kelly Clarkson? Oh, Jacob's there. Hey, Jacob and Jacob's mom. Hi, Tegan. Zachary, hey, buddy. Hey, David. Glad you can join us. Nice job. All right, Zachary, you can mute yourself. Jacob, you need to take this off. Take the hood off. We're in school. There you go. Good job. I like your haircut, though. I need to get mine trimmed just like that. There's Madison. Hey, Madison. Doing pretty good. We'll wait just a couple minutes, see if who else shows up. We've got 20 of us here. I think David's going. Oh, no, he's back. Make sure you guys have paper and pencil or pens or something, too. All right. Carter's ready. Thanks for the thumbs up, Carter. That was awesome. Chloe's good. Aiden's good. Cameron's good. Rob, do you have a question? Where are you? No, you're okay? Okay. Just a thumbs up. Please don't walk away. I want you guys to stay. Okay. Sorry, I got the joke. All right, let's see who else we got going on here. Oh, it's Friday. Gotta sing Friday I'm in Love by The Cure. Okay, we've got one more minute or so, and then we'll get started. Yes, who's talking?
Me.
Who's me?
Violet.
Oh, Violet. Yes, what do you need, Violet? Yes.
Do you like my drawing? An elephant queen.
An elephant queen. I like it. Nice job.
You can play me still.
I like it. Yeah. Melissa said it right. Wow. That was cool. All right. We'll go ahead and kind of get started here. There's 20 of you here, so that's amazing. So, hey, guys, welcome. We're on our official number 6 class video chat, so I'm excited to see all of you here. Hopefully maybe a couple just jump in. Manuel Herrera was going to join us in about 10 minutes, maybe a little bit less. I wanted him to come in after we got all settled and everything. So again, make sure you have everything ready, pencils, paper, whatever. And we'll get started whenever he gets here. And I want to introduce him too. All right. Guys, I'm really proud of you. You're doing a good job trying to stay on top of your assignments. I appreciate that. You're really, you know, trying to do as much as you can. And I know it's a lot. For some of you, it's easy and you just get it all done super quick. And some of you are really struggling to get half of it done. So I want to make sure you guys understand it. I'm just looking for you to continue to do your best, okay? Hey, look who's here. It's Manuel. Can you unmute yourself? Let's see here.
Yes. Can you guys hear me?
Yes. Hey, welcome.
Fantastic. How are you guys?
We're doing quite well. So thank you. Thank you so much for joining us. I know you're an educator and a busy guy and everything like that. So thank you. Thanks for stopping.
Yeah, no problem. I'm super excited to do this. This is always fun. I get to draw. Are you kidding me?
Right?
I love it. How are you guys out there?
Everyone give thumbs up. You can kind of give them a round of applause. And
awesome. Well, I hope you're excited to do this, to draw. I'm super excited to share you what I've done with drawing and what I do with kids, kind of in all grade levels.
Yeah.
I mean, I work with kindergarten all the way to high school. So it's pretty interesting to see, you know, the different drawings, the different creations that kids make, considering it's such a wide spectrum, yet everybody's in a different place, you know? So I'm really, in the end, I hope it just make it drawing fun if it's not fun for you. So super excited about that.
Yeah, absolutely. Can you tell us a little bit about your background and what's going on? And then I want to eventually give you the rights to actually share. Can you share your screen?
Oh, I can do that. Okay. Okay, you know what? That might be easier. I may call you on my iPad. I didn't do that. I set up a camera that I can just tilt down if that's okay.
Saya, go ahead and mute Saya. Hold on a second. All right. Sorry, go for it.
No worries. Dean, I just have my camera set up and I can bend it down and I can just show my iPad if that's okay. Since I called from my phone because I thought it would be easier for you guys, not knowing if I could share an iPad screen.
Yeah. Whatever works best. I just want you to have presentation form so they can see what you're doing. So sure, you're the bigger screen, not me.
Okay. Okay. Well, we'll try it out. And if it doesn't work, I'll call you back on my iPad and share the screen. So we'll just kind of go with this and I'll just turn my camera.
Okay.
Whenever. But yeah, so this is the fun part when I get to tell kids and teachers a little bit about me.
Yeah.
Is because I show like how drawing can be used to communicate that message. So I'm going to turn my camera around. How do I do that? Switch camera. Half of my screen is covered. Okay. So that's my house. let me bend this down a little bit. Oh man. Hang on. I closed my phone out. Okay. Can you see my iPad here?
I can see it. Can you guys give me a thumbs up if you can see it too? All right.
So can you guys see that pretty good? Pretty well?
And one thing you guys can do unless you do presentation, if they pin yours, then it becomes bigger. So if you guys, there's like a little pin thing. If you stick that, if you hit it, it'll actually make his screen bigger.
Awesome. So it looks like some of the kids are saying that they can see it. So usually what I do with these is I have the kids call out, but since we're kind of in this kind of setup, I'm just going to go through what I usually get as answers. So, you guys can see kind of who I am. So Dean, can you see that? Are you able to see that pretty well?
Yeah, it's up and down if you can turn it 90 degrees.
There we go.
Perfect, yes.
Okay, so is that better?
Yes, love it.
Okay, cool. So I usually like to show this because I like to show people that drawings can communicate the same way words can, but drawings sometimes are faster at communicating information. Two people. So I usually show this picture and have everybody call out kind of a little bit about me. And usually the first one that gets called out is usually, is this one here. It's a taco.
Yeah.
I'm from Texas. I love tacos. You guys out in California love tacos. So we can relate a little bit. But yeah, I kind of go around and I talk about, I enjoy playing golf. I don't golf very well. So if you guys have golfers in the classroom or parents, well, that are golfers, it's fun. It's a little upsetting because we can't go play now, but you know, it's okay. I look like Nolan.
I'm right there with you in terms of I like to golf, but I'm not good.
It's, you know, as long as I have fun, I'm okay with it. So this is a picture of a cell phone, supposed to be a cell phone saying cheese. I love to take pictures of stuff I do with my kids, stuff I do with teachers. This is a picture of me. I'm gonna go do this.
Yeah.
Oh, let me do this. So you guys can see a little better. So this is a picture of me and my boys. That's obviously me in the middle being the bigger. I actually have a second grader and a fifth grader. So very similar ages. One is in here kind of watching me. So this is the arch. I don't know if you guys are familiar with the arch, but that's one of the landmarks in the US, and that is in St. Louis. It's kind of cool. I didn't know until I moved here that you can actually go into the arch. Now here's another one that some kids get, some kids don't. But I've been a teacher. I've been in education for 17 years. This is actually my 18th year in education. And wow. I used to teach math. I taught math in middle school. So I was one of those crazy ones that like to have some of the kids that are a lot of fun when they get to be that age.
Lucky you.
I'm an artist. Like I love to draw, and I recently illustrated my first book, and I'm going to kind of show you a couple of those things. And Dean, thank you, by the way, for that video. That video was awesome. I love the video you made with some of those illustrations in it.
Oh, you're welcome.
Very cool. So a bike, simple. I like to ride bikes. I ride bikes with my kids. I ride bikes in races. And then These are shoes. I'm a runner. I also do a lot of running. I do a lot of running, biking, and swimming. I didn't put that in there. But I even do triathlons now.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. So this one, some people say I'm handy or I like to do carpentry. Well, all I really like to do is make lemonade stands. that's really about as far as my carpentry skills have gotten is lemonade stands. And then this is supposed to be me in the middle. And I've got a picture of Texas in the middle of my shirt because that's originally where I'm from. That is near and dear to me. So, yeah, that's me kind of in a nutshell. And if I had given you this picture, you probably could have looked through that in about 30 seconds and realized a little bit about me. So remember this because we'll talk about this a little bit later. But, yeah, that's me in a nutshell. Something I recently did for the first time is I'm illustrating a kid's book. So I don't know if you guys can see that. It's called Aggie and the Thought Compass. And I actually had an author reach out to me and wanted me to illustrate her book for her. So that was really cool. I didn't write the story, but I drew all the pictures.
Do you know when it's coming out?
I don't. We were hoping to get it done by May. And so it would be printed by May. But because of everything that's going on, we had a lot of delays.
Yeah.
And we're actually finishing up some final drawings now. So I will let you know as soon as it comes out. I'll let you know. I'm pretty excited about it.
Please, she's a
counselor in the school, and that's kind of what it's about. So, yeah. Here's a couple of drawings. You guys get to see some of the things kind of firsthand. This is the this is Aggie, the main character. You'll see this this fella here pretty soon. This is a unicorn, but we'll talk about him in a little bit. But yeah, that's one of the illustrations. Hopefully these are coming through pretty well.
Yeah, no, I can see them again. Again, guys, make sure if you pin his picture, it gets much larger. Nolan, you can stop with the little stuff, okay?
And so, again, another picture. It's about the kid and their family, and they go to get ice cream. So I had to learn to draw ice cream cones and ice creams and an ice cream shop. That's one thing about drawing is you're always learning to draw something new that you're not familiar with. So that was a fun challenge for me to do this book. And a map, kind of a treasure map that'll be, and we'll talk about this treasure map too in a little bit.
Oh, cool.
And so one of the things I love to draw, and I love to draw like kind of for the art side of it. But I also draw and teach kids how to think. And I use drawing to help them think through some of the things that they're working on. And this is an example of it. This is an example of kids having an idea for a project. And using drawings to help communicate that. And there's a whole activity for it. Dean, I can give that to you later. And if you want to try this with the kids, you can.
Sure.
But the idea was to get as many ideas about a project as you can before you ever make it. And so in this scenario, this student had seven ideas until they got stuck and they have, I don't know. and that's okay. But it helps to communicate your thinking to other people. So people know what you're talking about when they can actually see it. That's why drawing, I think, is really, really important with kids. And
I love it.
Oh, go ahead.
No, it's, okay. One of the things that what I do is I read chapter books to the kids almost every day, and I have them take notes. And I told them they can do one of two things. They can take like actual word notes or draw pictures that go along with the story, because like you said, it can tell a story. You don't have to write the words. You can still look at the pictures and figure it out. And some of them do that.
Yeah, it's kind of how I did it as a kid. I've been doing this my entire life. I was kind of the kid who some teachers didn't get because I didn't write notes and words. I wrote notes and pictures. And luckily, my teachers allowed me to do some of that during some of their classes. And it does. It helps me remember what it is I read or what somebody's read to me. And this is a perfect lead-in to this. So this is actually a fifth grade, I came into the classroom to talk about drawing, and they were reading a chapter book. I can't remember what the chapter book was called, but the main character's name was Keck. I can't remember what it was called. And then their companion in here was this cow. If you can see it, there you go. But what I did was I asked the kids to tell me what you know about Keck. Like I hadn't read any of the book. The kids probably had read a couple of chapters, and I said, okay, I'm going to show you how I draw these things. And this is what I did. It's kind of just like a character map of what they knew about the main character. And I kind of just branched off into little individual pieces. they called an airplane a flying boat, which was interesting. They had never been to, I think, America. And to get to America, they had to go in a flying boat. And they called, that's what they called an airplane, which I thought was pretty, pretty interesting. And yeah. then we started to get into the story a little bit and the different things that were happening. And we kind of just made like a little T-chart of some of those things. And then what I did is I printed this on a huge poster. So you see all this white space that's there. I printed two of these posters, put it in their classroom, and I let the kids draw the rest of it. So they told me what they knew up to that point, and then I let the kids take over. And we did two posters, so enough students could actually go in, up to the wall and draw on it, and multiple at a time. And it, you know, it, everybody had a turn to draw something. So it was kind of cool. It was a great activity.
I love it.
I encourage kids to, you know, try to do that. I guess the next big piece was what I deal with a lot, not deal with a lot, but what I talk to kids a lot about is there is some anxiety around drawing. There's some like, I can't draw very well. I don't like the way my drawing looks. And this is true for teachers too. So kids, if you were in there and you're like, I love to draw, that may not always be the case for some of your teachers. And so it's kind of nice to encourage them. So I give them these fun activities, which you guys are going to do. To kind of get some confidence in drawing and show you that it's just a way to express yourself and think. And, you know, the pretty side of it can come at some point. But once you get comfortable putting pencil to paper, it just becomes a little less worrisome. So I'm going to have you guys get your pencils or pens or markers or whatever you have. And I want you guys to get ready because we're going to actually do an activity together. And this is just to kind of loosen up your hands, loosen up your arms, your wrists, and your pencil. So what I want you to do, I'll give you another few seconds to get everything ready.
Right, give me a thumbs up if you guys are ready. If I see it, show me a thumbs up. You're ready. You're good. I know Violet's ready. Not yet, Jacob. Yeah, all right. You can just watch along, but it looks like Chloe G, you're good. All right, like we're ready. Go.
Okay, awesome. So what I want you to do is I want you to use your paper, use your pencil and your paper. And if you guys can see this, this is what I'm calling a squiggle. I want you to create five or six of those. And I'm going to show you how I drew mine. And it doesn't matter how you draw it. You're just going to put your pencil to the paper. And you're just going to draw a squiggle. And I want you to draw, I don't know, four or five of them. Just like this. And space them out. Make sure you have plenty of room on your paper. My paper is kind of small. I'm going to make my paper a little bigger. I get to cheat. I'm using an iPad. But you definitely don't have to use an iPad. You can do this with just a piece of paper and pen. So I'll give you a few seconds. Go ahead and take your time.
You said about four or five of them?
Yeah, four or five, six. This is also just a good warm-up to make kind of this doodle. Because before I start to draw, I still do some of those exercising. It's kind of like when you go to PE and before you start, the teacher or the coach usually has you do some warm-ups. Right. You kind of have to do that in drawing too, because your wrist isn't quite awake, your fingers aren't quite awake, or they're not used to making some lines. And this is a good activity to do that. I'm moving my stuff around because I didn't follow my own directions and space these out. All right. So they're squiggles, right? We probably took about, I don't know, 60 seconds to draw those squiggles, right? That was pretty quick. So now what I want you to do is I'm gonna draw this in a different color just so you can see a little better on the screen. Is I'm gonna teach you how to turn those squiggles that you made in 60 seconds into beautiful birds. Now I bet when you drew these squiggles, you didn't think that these were going to be birds. I'm even gonna spin this around just so you don't think I'm cheating. I turned it back upside down, which there is really no right or wrong way. Now to turn these into birds, what you have to do is you just need to add a beak, an eye, and a leg, or a couple of legs. And just like that, you have a bird.
Oh my gosh.
So I'm turning my paper around too. So I want you to try it, and you can turn any squiggle into a bird. I'm gonna even add a tail on mine. It's just gonna be a triangle. Bam! Look at that. That, my friend, is a bird.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna try. It's not the perfect bird. It's not the best bird, right? Yeah, well, some of you might be. This might be one of the best birds you've ever drawn. But that, my friends, is a bird. Now I'm looking at this one. That one looks like that's going to be tough, but there is not, I guarantee there's not a squiggle that I haven't found that I can't turn into a bird. You can even change the direction of how your bird is flying or standing. Oh, I don't want to do that. There you go. Look at this. This is my bird dive bombing a worm or something. Look at that. That, my friends, that is a bird. Let me do this one. So yeah, this is show your parents later. Look, I bet I can draw 6 birds in like 120 seconds or 2 minutes. This is kind of how I want you to think about drawing when you first start off, if this is something new to you. This was pretty kind of, I didn't use much brain power to create some squiggles and to create these birds. But if I were to be talking about a bird and I needed to express the idea of a bird, I can do it pretty quickly. That squiggle took 5 seconds to draw, 3 seconds to draw. The beak took another 2 or 3. And then we can say it's a bird, and then we can move on. We're not getting caught up in, that bird doesn't have this color, that bird doesn't have that color. So if you were taking notes in a story and it was talking about an animal or a bird or a person, I just want you to think about drawing it really quickly so that you can get that idea out, and you can always come back and add detail. I can come back later and I can shade in these birds, or I can color their feathers, or I could give them some other kind of texture, but I don't need to do that right now. I just need to get it down pretty quickly and kind of move on, and I'll have time to elaborate later. So I want you to try this. I want you to try this with your parents. Give them a marker, family relative, somebody, a sibling, brother, sister, cousin, whoever might be there. Tell them you're going to teach them how to draw birds in less than like 2 minutes and use the squiggles. Awesome. So yeah, kind of cool, right? Never thought you were going to draw, 6 beautiful birds.
I'm following along too. I did 5. I don't know if you can see it.
That's perfect. Look at that. That looks like a turkey. That almost looks like a
turkey. I know that one did.
Oh, yours came out great.
That's pretty funny.
That's awesome. So yeah, you can even do this with, you could either create other animals. It's kind of interesting when you add different characteristics to that are part of something. When you add it to something that's very abstract, you can turn it into something. So this is what you would call a stylized drawing as you start to draw. Like, it's a bird. It's not drawn perfectly, but it's drawn in a neat, fun style. So you're now done stylized drawing. So there you go. You guys learned some more things.
Hey, thumbs up if you guys did it. You can bring it up to this camera.
Oh, yeah, bring it up to the screen. Let's see you guys. I'm on my phone, so I can't see, but you guys can see each other's.
Yeah. Go get it really close, you guys. Really close to the camera. Oh, there we go. Thanks, Alice. Nice job. Oh, Connor, those are great. Oh, my gosh. That's amazing. Amanda, good job. I love it. Aiden, way to go. Love it. Looks really good. Oh, Nolan, I can see yours. I like your squiggly one, Nolan. That's good. Oh, Zachary, that's cool. Looks like it's flying. That's neat. Let me see, Sophia. Oh, yeah, you did a lot of them. Nice job. Well done. All right, guys, you can put them down. Good job. I love it. Well done.
Okay, awesome. I'm glad you guys did it. Okay, fantastic. So now we're going to go on, kind of keep going, kind of build some more confidence. Hopefully everybody's confident in the birds that they have created. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the rest of what you need to know in order to draw pretty much anything. We've kind of talked about the squiggles, and we talked about the birds and drawing really quickly. Make sure this is – Mr. Deaver, you can see this, correct? You can see the screen?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. So this is another exercise you guys can do in learning how to draw, because there's really only 8 pieces that I even think about when I draw – shapes, or when I draw things that I want to create. So some of the illustrations that I've drawn are just, they're just made up of shapes, and I've put those shapes together to make a drawing. Kind of like when you're learning to spell new words, you just put letters together and they spell those words. That's kind of like how drawing works. And there are only 8 things you need to know in order to draw just about anything. So you guys are also going to do this too. So if you have a clean spot on your paper, or if you want to turn your paper over, or if you have another sheet of paper, you can do this. If not, you can just follow along, and I'll send this to Mr. Deaver later, and he can send it to you again. But we're going to start off with drawing the most basic thing there is in drawing, and that is a dot. So it's not, as silly as this sounds, I want us to draw a bunch of little dots just to kind of get our kind of warm up. So I'm just going to draw little dots, basically small circles or taps of your pen or paper. Those are dots. Those will come in handy. Those will turn into something later. So it's kind of good to exercise some of those things. Markers work really well for dots. Pencils are a little difficult. Pens are a little difficult. Markers are beautiful for dots because it's easy to put ink to paper. Okay, the second one, the second basic thing you need to know is when I have a bunch of dots or a bunch of points, I can create a line. And sounds silly, sounds basic, I know. I am not insulting your intelligence. I'm basically just showing you, practice drawing lines. I love to draw lines. You can draw lines that are perfectly straight. You can draw lines that are a little crooked. You can even draw loopy lines. These are all lines. These are a bunch of points that have been connected together that make a line. Make mine wavy. Again, it sounds silly, but it's warming you're already warming your wrist up. So we have a dot, and we have a line. Now the next thing we're going to teach you, and this is pretty easy, are squares and rectangles. And I want you to really practice squares and rectangles. I know it's probably boring. You've probably drawn squares and rectangles since you were little, but I'm telling you, you can't go wrong when you put these together. So I'm drawing squares and rectangles all over my paper. You can even connect them. And then when you get fancy, you make 3D objects. Oh, that's lesson two. We'll do that next time. That's lesson two. We do them next time.
We have to pay for that lesson.
Yeah, that's for the premium account.
Yeah, exactly.
So squares, and then I'm going to give you a couple of guesses as to what is next. It's going to be a triangle. So when you think of triangles, also think of different size triangles or different shapes. Connecting lines again to make these polygons. Whoa, lost my pencil. That's a beak of a bird. That's maybe the bill of a hat. That's maybe a mountain. Hint, hint. Triangles.
What program are you using on the iPad?
I use Procreate. I love it, hands down. I mean, it does cost. It's $10. A little high for not. I wouldn't say even high. It's $10, and it's worth every penny. Because I do a lot of illustrations on it, and I have layers. So I'm not sure if you're familiar with Photoshop, but it has layers where I can stack things and kind of sort things. So
nice.
I definitely highly recommend spending the $10. The next thing is going to be circles. And circles, I like to draw circles. I love to draw circles. Circles take practice. I never really draw a perfect circle, but that's okay. But circles are fun to draw. We can get into a bigger conversation later about, I'm very much a wrist drawer. I draw a lot with my wrist.
Okay.
Usually when you teach, you draw with your whole arm. So that's another thing. That's another premium thing, but yeah. If I was there, you guys could see me. I could show you. It's a little hard doing it on camera. But circles. And we've got three more. And one you've already done, so we're not going to spend too much time on this. But a squiggle. I like squiggles a lot. Squiggles look like a lot of different things. But that's just a squiggle. Squiggles can be coloring in. Squiggles can be a lot of different things. I'll zoom that in a little bit. There you go. And the last two, I'm going to make my paper a little bigger and give you guys a little more time. Can I get to cheat? So I'm here. The next one is a blob. So think of your blob as kind of like a cloud. That's a blob. Those will come in handy sometime.
Love blobs.
Blobs are fantastic. And blobs can be anything. They don't have, oops, I just erased them. Blobs can just be these. So like, watch this. If I did a blob like this, and I were to take the color, I just made, whoop. I basically just made, well, that didn't work out. I just made a lake.
Yeah.
And that's all I'm using is my blob.
From a blob.
Cool. So that's why it's important, like, to learn these shapes is a blob. That blob, I can add little waves in there. Then I can put grass if I had a green color. And all we drew was a blob. But look at that. That already turned into a little pond or a little lake.
That's awesome.
Kind of crazy, right? And you know what? I'm gonna one-up myself right here. Now, I'm going to do this. You know what goes on a lake? And I'm going to use orange. It's my little duck.
Oh gosh, yeah, it's a duck.
You know what my duck? You know what my duck is made up of? Squiggles that we did earlier. Look at that. It's not the best duck. Hey, friend.
But it worked.
But yeah, it works. So, and then the last one, I guess I'd have to say is a personal favorite because I live here. Let me change my brush again. My last one is an arch. Those will come in handy too. Because you can do them upside down. Remember, I want you to remember the arch because we're going to use that in a minute. Arches can be upside down. They can be sideways. You can lump them together. I don't know if you can see that. You can lump them together. This is what I learned from a student who is using arches. He would do a bunch of arches together, and if you add a circle to the top, you have people. So maybe you're talking about a group of people. This guy has a tie on, maybe he's got a jacket on, but now you have people. So maybe this is a group of people in your story, and you need to say a group of people, or you need to talk about a bunch of people, and you can put a cap on him. This is simple stuff that'll just help you communicate or think about your ideas.
I like it.
So there you go. Look at that. 8 things. But now I'm going to prove to you. I'm going to prove to you that you can draw just about anything because I'm going to show you some of my stuff that I've drawn using just these shapes. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I'm going to do this. So here are some of the things that I've drawn using this. So this right here this is how I draw mountains. I mean, these are usually I ask out loud, what shapes do you see? But I know I'm more than positive you guys know what you see. I see triangles, lines. These are my blobs because these are snow-capped mountains. But just like that, you're able to draw mountains really quickly. I know we used to talk, I taught 8th grade. And so we talked a lot about westward expansion, and westward expansion always right. includes the Appalachian Mountains. And yep. so we would draw mountains like that on our maps. Here are my trees. This is what my trees look like when I draw. These are just, the trees are just blobs. And I have my trunks, or I guess you can consider those lines, are really skinny rectangles, really skinny long rectangles.
Yeah.
And then these guys, I draw a lot of monsters. So this is, I told you to remember the arch later because the arch, this is an upside down arch. And the top has got some triangles. And those dots are his eyes. And more dots make his fur. I mean, you can draw anything like that you can kind of think of just by being silly with some of your shapes. That's how these monsters came to be. Like, it was totally just drawing a big arch upside down on just in a drawing. And I was like, oh, this, I can make this look like a monster. And then I've made it draw a bunch of little arches here to make his wings. That's usually how I do wings on birds when I draw feathers.
Super simple, but effective.
Yeah, exactly. And then here's my my unicorn with the space helmet, of course.
Yes.
But the unicorn is just, and I'm going to draw on top of this guy just to show you. I'm gonna draw a different color. I'm gonna kind of ruin him. But this is just my rectangle. This is a rectangle. His nose is a rectangle. His legs are two rectangles put together. And eventually you learn parts of an animal so that you can then, and these are squares on the ends. His horn is a big triangle. Mane, blobs. And that's it. You eventually just get better and better at smoothing corners and rounding corners. But once you kind of get the basics of kind of how to break up a shape, how to break up an object into shapes, you can draw just about anything. His wings are big blobs.
Yeah.
Or actually, I guess arches. I guess you can say they're arches. And then a line that connects them.
Huh.
So, yeah, let me turn this all off. And then eventually... I'm taking all these colors off. Then eventually you can color it in and look how much cooler they look. And just think, all those are triangles and blobs, guys. That's it. Triangles, blobs, rectangles. It's when you color it in, like it just kind of comes to life.
Yeah, for sure. So, oh, that's cool.
And then my monsters. Ta-da.
Love it.
All right. I think people are the last thing I'm going to show you. And then I'm going to leave you guys with some stuff. And does anybody have any questions, or do you want to do questions or anything?
Sure.
I'm up for anything.
Yeah. Let's see. I think Connor, you have a question. Okay. Go ahead and unmute yourself there.
Do I make mistakes a lot of the times? Yeah.
Oh yes, Connor, you have no idea. Let me show you this. Let me see if I can tilt this down. There we go. Okay, Connor, I don't know if you can see all this, but can you see what these are?
Yeah.
These are all my journals that I use. These are all little books that I draw in all the time. And these were all my mistakes are made. This is all the mistakes I made. That's how I get better. I can open, I'm not sure what I'll have on in any of these, but.
We lost you.
Yeah, we lost you.
We lost Manuel. Hopefully he'll come back. Hey, David. You need to, you know, find a place to sit and don't show your pets, okay? All right. Hopefully we'll get Manuel back in a minute or two. I don't know, we lost him. Connor, did you hear his answer though?
Yep.
Okay, good. I think you're gonna find any artist is gonna make mistakes, and it's what you do with it. Because sometimes mistakes end up being pretty cool.
Yeah.
All right. Let's go ahead and Manuel, you're muted still. So if you can unmute yourself. There you are.
There we go. Yeah, Connor. So these are all my books. These are all my journals that I have that I've drawn and written ideas in. And that's kind of where I mess up at. And that's totally fine, because in all of this messing up and redrawing and drawing again, eventually came my characters, eventually came the things that I put in a book. I think it's totally fine. Like I don't go without having one of these, journals. I'll send these directions to Mr. Deaver. I even make my own journals. So these are journals that I made myself out of cardboard and copy paper. And I use these at school, at work, because I just can't stop drawing for one thing. I love to draw that much, but it's great to have those for ideas. So I make mistakes a lot of the time, and I'm okay with that. I'm going to put this back on here. Let's see if I can move all these out of the way. Did anybody else have questions?
Anybody else raise their hand? They might have a question. Saya, you have a question?
Whoa.
Saya, do you have a question? You can unmute yourself. You can unmute yourself.
Yeah, I have a question.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a question. When you sometimes draw, do you ever make mistakes where it's really hard to fix them?
So your question was, do I ever mute your mic? Okay, so the question.
Hold on a second there. All right. Okay, go for it.
Okay, so the question was, do I ever make mistakes where it's really hard to mess up? Yes. And what's kind of cool about it is sometimes you turn it into something else. And sometimes it's good to practice mistakes. Let me see if I have one in here. This book real quick, and I'll show you what I mean. Yeah, so sometimes it's good to make mistakes because it turns them into something that you would have not thought about. Ooh, sorry. That was loud. Let me show you a journal that I have again, and it has something in here. So I don't know if you can see this, but these are what I would do is I make blobs of ink on a piece of paper, and the blobs are just blobs. I don't think about them. I just make blobs, and then I try to turn them into something that I wouldn't normally do. That really helps me. So when I do make a mistake, I have these ideas in the back of my mind that I can turn that mistake into. It's kind of like I practice making mistakes. I like these questions about mistakes. It really helps to practice. So like these are just like some lines I drew. I don't know how clear this is coming in.
It's good.
But these are lines that I drew just across a piece of paper, but I turned them into like fence posts or into cut off trees. So at some point, if I'm drawing or painting something and I want to draw over it, and I have this like random thing sticking out, maybe I'll turn it into one of these fence posts or one of these trees. But yeah, it's tough. And you kind of just have to love your mistakes. Love your mistakes and make them into something cool. Even if it's random and it doesn't make sense in the drawing, that still puts some kind of imagination into your picture. So I encourage you to make mistakes. And then you're like, okay, now what do I do with that? And come up with something off the wall that doesn't even go with the picture. And it'll just help push your creativity and kind of your thinking about images. So I do this with my boys a lot. We do activities like
Are they artists too?
Switch this. A little. They enjoy it, but they're not ones to sit around and draw. Like they don't. I remember that at that age, I was already sitting around drawing everything I could. These guys will do it. If I'm sitting here long enough, they'll come in, they'll grab some paper, and they'll sit, and I'll give them little challenges, which they like. So, they're video gamers and TikTokers.
Of course, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Exactly.
So if anybody out there who plays Fortnite, my son loves playing that. Any other questions?
Let's see. Any other hands raised? Jacob the same. Violet, you don't have a question for him? You're the ongoing artist. Violet, do you have a question? You do? Okay, what's your question?
My question is, do you ever like just keep on drawing for fun and like never stop until like the deadline?
Okay.
Go ahead and mute yourself.
Is it Saya?
Yeah. Saya, mute yourself. There you go.
There you go. Okay. So, Violet, thank you. That was a good question. Do I ever just draw for fun all the time? I just love to draw. Sometimes there's times where it's not even for a project. It's just I have a piece of paper or I have some time and I have my iPad. I just like to draw. It's just fun. It's fun for me to do. I try to draw things. Recently, I've been trying to draw things that I wouldn't normally draw because it's a challenge and I want to challenge myself. There's definitely a lot of things that I've drawn over and over and over and over again. And sometimes you get bored. So it's kind of cool to pick something out that you wouldn't normally draw, or something that you think is really hard to draw. And I try to break it up into shapes, put it together in my head, and then try to draw that. You know, I recently had to draw the ice cream shop. I didn't really know how to draw an ice cream shop. I've never drawn an ice cream shop. And so that was a challenge for me. And that was fun. It was fun to kind of, I also go and look online for pictures, whether they're real pictures or other illustrators' pictures. If you like to draw, I would definitely encourage you to find someone that you like and look at all of their work. Copy their work, try to draw what they draw. And eventually, once you have four or five people that you like how they draw and you try to draw them, you'll kind of put those all together into one style of drawing that becomes yours. So there are definitely some people that I love, and I feel like the style that I draw in is a combination of all of those artists. Kids books are a great place to go and look, like little kids books, like, you know, kids, like if you have little brothers and sisters, books you're reading to them, I like to look at those books because they have some really good illustrators. And my favorite one is Oliver Jeffers. He wrote The Day the Crayons Quit.
That's a good one.
He's my favorite artist. He just did a TED Talk. So Mr. Deaver, if you look that up, Oliver Jeffers TED Talk, he just did one a couple of days ago. It's really cool.
Okay.
And it's super short, like 10 minutes, but yeah.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. Does that answer your question?
My dad's actually an artist.
That's perfect. So you definitely, like, you should watch your dad draw and see if you can, like, put your own spin on it. That's what I would do. I would love to, like, see what you do with your dad's art, your dad's style of art. My kids do that. They copy some of my art and they kind of make it their own, which is kind of cool. So that's awesome. You're lucky. You get to have an artist in house. It's really cool. That's true.
Yeah. All right, good job, Violet. Good to meet yourself.
I would like to also show you a drawing that I've been working on.
Okay, go
for it. I'd love to see it. Uh-oh, what happened? Oh, I see it. Is that a dragon dog? It's kind of off the screen. I'm sorry.
It's an elephant queen.
It's an elephant queen. I'm so sorry. It was kind of off to the side. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. Do you draw for fun?
Yes, always. Yeah.
Always.
Ask my mom, like, can I have a break to draw?
Well, keep doing it. Keep doing it. I love it. And I hope everything is hanging up in your room that you're drawing, because that's super proud. Like, you got to be super proud of your stuff. Awesome.
Nice job, Violet. Go ahead and mute yourself. And I think, Chloe, you have a question for him? And Hayden, mute yourself, okay?
My question for Manuel Herrera is,
mm-hmm.
What is one of your best drawings?
Oh, what is one of my best drawings? You know, I'm going to say that book cover I showed you, that I'm pretty proud of that. That's probably one of my best drawings because it's going to be printed in a book. Like, I've never had any of my art printed in a book. And that gets to be on a cover. I'll send it to Mr. Deaver, so maybe he can send it out to you guys again. I also have some other stuff to give you, to give everyone. But I'll send that to you. That's probably my favorite piece of art because it's going to be printed on a book. I can hold it in my hand, and I can go on the, I can go online and buy it. That's going to be so cool to buy my own book on anything, on Amazon, on Barnes and Noble. So yeah, that's probably my favorite drawing. I'll send it to you guys so you guys can look at it a little more up close.
That'd be so cool. And I know that's a great feeling because it could end up anywhere in the world, you know,
right, someone's reading
your book.
I'm super excited. So yeah, that was a good question, Chloe. Thank you.
Good job. All right. Any other questions?
Yeah.
I don't see. Thank you, Chloe. You can mute yourself. Good job. No one else has a question. No one raised their hand or anything. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to show you one more. That's okay. If we have, do we still have time? Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
We lost them for a second here.
Put my camera, and I'm going to do my best to mount this back onto this thing. Oh no!
I can hear you.
Can you guys hear me?
You can see your front door. There you go.
Okay. Can you guys see me? Okay. There we go. All right. So I'm going to do this. So I'm going to show you how I draw people really quickly. And I'm also going to send you something too with this, but you're going to draw probably a lot of people if you enjoy drawing and you enjoy drawing to take notes. But I always have to think that I've got to draw this kind of quickly. And used to, when I used to draw people, I used to draw them kind of like, make sure this is on here. I used to draw people like this. You know, we kind of draw stick figures, right? Everybody's drawing a stick figure. But when I'm drawing because I'm trying to tell a story or trying to capture some kind of story I'm reading, I don't know what that person looks like compared to that person, because my stick people were always looking the same. So what I started to do was I started to draw my people like this, kind of like my rectangle with an open, kind of like a rectangle with my, with an open top. And then I would draw a circle. I draw legs, which are lines, feet. I draw arms with elbows. And then if I needed to draw any details inside of them, I can draw them in here. So if it was going to be a boy, a girl, a man, a woman, an older person, I could draw some of those things that they might be wearing. If I were to draw a lady and I knew she wore a dress, I would just draw kind of like this big open top triangle. And then I would draw a head. I'd draw feet. So then I can add detail. So maybe I know my character in the book always wore a polka dotted dress. So now, and then she had long hair. So I could draw her like this. And this was her dad who always went to work and he wore a tie. But now I can tell the difference between those two. Dean, can you, you can hear me, correct?
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Okay, okay, I'm just making sure. So I want you to practice drawing some people yourself, and you don't have to fill them in, but it just kind of practice drawing arms and legs, and they kind of look funny because they have a big belly and everything, but it's more so for me to just take notes. Maybe this guy has on a sweater vest for some reason. They might talk about that in the story. Or maybe my girl, maybe this is a mom and she has on a necklace and she has curly hair. Look at that. Here comes those blobs. And maybe she has curly. Look at that. And that's, I can put little lines, but that's how I draw people. I mean, it's a quick way to get a person out. Draw longer lines. And then I can use color to color everything in. I'm going to show you what a group of people looks like. I can't remember if Mr. Deaver put this in the video, but here are my people. So,
yeah, I like those.
Mr. Deaver, I'll send this to you. I can send this to you too as well. But you can see here that here's my circle plus my kind of upside down arch with a rectangle with top lines, and that makes a person. But then if you add details, so I keep doing this wrong. Here we go. Okay, so here's one of my favorite artists. Let me turn this off. There we go. It's Frida Kahlo. So that's kind of what she looks like. Here's Curtis Scott King.
You're able to capture them in such so little space, and you can see who they are.
Yeah, it's funny just by adding these little small details. Frederick Douglass, George Washington, little small details like. It's enough to communicate that idea. And yeah, I was really surprised that I kind of challenged myself to make multiple people because I was telling people that they should be drawing this way. And I was like, well, I'm going to challenge myself to see how many people I can make. Amelia Earhart. Everybody knows who I would think maybe knows who that is. Mr. Harry Potter. I even put the little Z. Because see, he has a sweater vest and he has a little tie and his little wand. But I didn't have to get super, super detailed.
Obama.
President Obama. I have one more page. My next page is probably my favorite page because it has my favorite, one of my favorite artists. That's Mr. Bob Ross. So kind of cool. Any of you Marvel fans?
Yeah, I like that one. That one's good.
So yeah, again, people are just made up of just little lines and squares. So that's cool. and then Chewbacca. That was a challenge. I just covered Chewbacca in hair. Again, all I did was just go like this over and over and over and over until I got all of his hair. Those are just lines. There's nothing, you know, super fancy about that.
Looks really good.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to send you guys these things because I want you to practice and I want you to try to draw these if you can. I'm going to send you kind of this blank one and you turn these people into, hopefully turn them into different things. You can turn them into yourself. That would be a lot of fun. And see what you come up with. It'll be interesting to see how this fits into the way you draw, the way you think. I'm going to send you some of these coloring pages that I made.
Nice.
I've been at home a long time and getting pretty bored. And so I have some friends that are like, hey, can you send me some coloring pages? And so these are some of their requests. We have your standard unicorn. If you'd like to draw it, I'd like to see you put something on him. Like I had, the moon helmet or the space helmet on him. You can maybe give him a shirt, him or her, and then you give him a name here at the bottom. I'll send you, this was an interesting request. So look at this. So this is my my rectangles. Remember I told you about rectangles? This is just the same shape. I draw a lot of my animals the same. But somebody requested a zebra with a cape chewing bubble gum.
So, I love it.
Did I make a lot of mistakes on this one? Absolutely. I had to draw this over and over. And then I had to look up zebra online. I looked up zebra to see, like, did I get the stripes right? You know, did I get, you know, the tail right? Does it have the same tail as a horse or a whatever? You guys use the internet to help you find ideas.
And then a llama. Look at that.
This is a llama corn. It's a little different. So I'm going to send this to you guys too. So definitely color your llama corn and name it, you know, something fun. And then I'll send you this blank lemonade stand and see what you guys make with it. You can just fill in. I'll show you another one more picture of it. And then I want you to practice doing you. Draw you in the middle and use your shapes and come up with, you know, five or six different things that represent who you are.
Yeah, I love that. I love that idea. That's really neat.
This is what I'm going to show you. I thought I had him here somewhere. Oh, yeah, this is what I turned my it crashed. This is what I turned my lemonade stand into. Sort of turned it into... That is a squirrel. I don't know if you can tell, that is a squirrel selling tacos. So,
and the guacamole is free, which is really rare.
You know, yes, very, very rare, especially during these times. So, feel free to turn your lemonade stand into something, and I love the video that you sent with all these pictures that I had.
Yeah,
these are some of the other requests. That somebody asked me to make a nugget king or a nugget lord. So there's my chicken. I didn't know how to draw chicken nuggets. I had to learn how to draw chicken nuggets.
That one cracked me up. I loved it when it saw nugget lord. That was really funny.
Yeah, this was a friend. They had some kids, and they said they want a nugget lord. I said, a nugget lord they shall have. So, I'm going to turn this off. And I'm just going to flip this around.
And I can't remember. Do you have a website if, like, someone wanted to either purchase your drawings or request something?
Yeah. It's just manualdraws.com. Pretty simple.
Okay.
I do little journal books. So if you want us to put some together for you, like these little journals like this, I've made them for classes, for classrooms. Oh, this is actually, I think I got one of my kids. He's going to love that I put his drawings. He's looking at me with some side eye there.
I love it. It's good.
I didn't know this was yours, Gray. I'm sorry. This is your journal. This is his journal. There he wants to say hi.
Hey, hello.
I would love to do this again. You guys, if you want to show me what you create next time, that would be awesome to see. It'd be a lot of fun. Yeah, just keep drawing, keep doing it. Put it in school. Put it into some of your notes that you're taking. See what you come up with.
Yeah.
And I'll send you those pictures and things, and you guys can download them. You can put them on an iPad and draw over them. But it'd be cool to see what you guys do.
Yeah, what do you guys think? Thumbs up, hand, you can do the applause. What can you do here?
Yeah, I can see some of you. Awesome.
Yeah, no, that was really cool, man. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you, Connor. Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Thank you, Connor and Chloe and
Zachary, Violet.
Violet, Zachary, yeah, you guys asking great questions, and it was a lot of fun. So, yeah, if you need anything else, guys, let me know. I'm excited to talk to you.
Will do. I this class is really good at asking questions.
they're really good.
Yeah, we've been all year long. This is a really good questioning class. And so, let's see. Someone asked a question. Can I show my drawing of an eye? Okay, Amanda, sure. Go ahead. Pull it up to the camera. Let's see it. Oh my gosh.
Let me see if I can get him. What is his name?
It's Amanda. She's should be at towards the top there.
Amanda. Let me see if I can get to her. Amanda starts with an F, last name?
Yes, the F with the last name, yeah.
Oh, look at that eye. Holy cow.
I know.
You're very talented. I like how you drew that eye. You even have the highlight in the eye.
Yeah.
Eyes, man. That is like a rite of passage when you become when you start to draw. Everybody draws eyes, and it's so interesting to see that. That's beautiful, Amanda. Thank you.
Well done.
Wow, well done. Like, even, like, just the detail in your eye. Like, oh, my gosh.
Wow.
That's awesome.
Good job. Yeah, yeah. I didn't even know she could do that.
There you go. Like, it's a prize that's telling when you do some of this. And then some of the kids who enjoy doing it, oh, I can do this in class. And then you see, like, this other side of them. Yeah, it's interesting to see the different styles everybody has and what influences everybody. I think Connor has a question.
Yeah, Connor, do you have a question?
Something that happened. So I was doing my normal classwork, but I just wanted to add like fun stuff to it, but then like this computer wouldn't like it. So I just took it all off.
Oh, no, don't. Yeah, if it's okay to show it. Like, sometimes you just want to put it on something, and that's okay to show that. You have to just be confident in what you draw and be excited that you like it, because somebody somewhere likes it. I can relate, though, Connor. I know what you mean. There's times where I drew stuff where I didn't think anybody would like it, and then finally I kind of just knew that I like it. And so I put it on there, and then it was surprising to see somebody somewhere saying, no, I do like that. And so it's keep putting stuff out. Like, you have to keep putting stuff out and just know that you like it and be happy that you like it. And that's all that matters. So good luck to you, Connor. Like, send me, if you want to send something to Mr. Deaver and so I can look at it too, I would love to. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, absolutely. I know River Broto, we call him Brodo, but it's starts with the R, his first name. His last name is Roy Chaudhry. He has a question for you. Brodo.
Okay. Go ahead.
Yeah, the way you draw your characters, how do you draw them sideways? Because all of them were looking front. How do you draw them, like, looking sideways?
Oh, that's a very good question. Sideways is hard. I'm trying to think if I have many. I will be honest with you and say that sometimes I avoid drawing them sideways because it's so hard. I'm trying to look if I have one recent. That's a really good question. And that is probably going to be, you know, my answer is that I just kind of avoid doing it. I'm looking to see.
Go with your strength, right? Go with your strength.
Yeah. I'm trying to go with my strength. It's tough. Yeah, I draw my people like this, or I draw them like that, or I draw them. I don't know if you can see me, but I don't draw them too often. So I'm going to take that as a challenge. I'm going to draw some people sideways.
Okay, bro. Just nice job. Way to challenge him.
Thank you. I'm gonna do that. I'm looking at my drawings now. I'm like, yeah, they all face the front. I'm gonna do it just for you, man. And I'm gonna post it online, and you can see it. I'm gonna draw something sideways. Somebody standing sideways. Just because of that. Do you draw your people sideways?
Yeah, I draw them usually sideways. I don't draw too much front.
So we could work well together. So you draw all my pictures sideways. I'll draw all your pictures front ways. I think we're going to take on the world.
totally could. A couple more questions, and then let's see. Bye, Chloe G. She left. And then Hayden, you want to show your dragon. Okay.
Hayden.
Is Hayden still here? Oh, there he is. Hayden? Okay. Oh, Hayden with an H.
Okay. Hayden Maxwell. All right.
Real close there, Hayden.
Oh, look at that beautiful dragon.
Nice.
Awesome. That's a lot of detail. You love the detail. Yeah. I mean, the teeth, the scales. You know, keep that dragon, man. Keep it and then keep practice drawing that dragon over and over and over and over again, because he'll just get better and better and better. And then go back and look at that. Start now and then go back when school starts and go back and look at that drawing and see how much better you've gotten, how much smoother your lines get, how much quicker you can draw him. It's good to find a character you like and draw him over and over and over again. But also draw him front ways and sideways. Otherwise, you'll get stuck like me and only draw him sideways. That's really cool, Hayden. I'm really proud of you for that. That's a lot of detail in a drawing. It looks awesome, man.
I agree. All right. Let's see real quick. Sophia, you want to show your monsters?
Sophia.
With an S. Did she? Where is she? Oh, there she is. Okay. Real close, Sophia. Real close.
Oh, hey, you drew monsters like mine. I love it. And you changed them up. Oh, I love those monsters.
Sophia, did you do that just right now? Sophia, did you do that just right? She did? Okay.
Yeah, did? Awesome. I love
them. Oh, my gosh.
I would love to see him. Like, go find a marker and color him in and see what you come up with. Oh, I love it. Thank you. Thank you, Sophia.
I like that. Nice job. All right. All right, Madison, let's make you the last one here. Can I show the drawing of me? All right, Madison.
Madison Moberg?
Yes.
Whoa, look at that. I love that. Oh,
that's
wow.
Really good.
That's beautiful. So you use the shapes to make your whole body? Yeah. And then eventually you'll get better. And then like sometimes those shapes will just disappear and it'll be one big drawing. But you got to break it up into pieces just like that. Like if you look at fashion designers draw people, they draw them very much like you just drew them. That looks like it's very much those shapes. Yeah. So cool.
All right, guys. Well, we need to end this, but can you, first of all, give him a huge round of quiet applause. Let's see it here.
Yay.
Nice
Thank
job.
You guys.
And I'm going to take a picture of us. So if you guys can all get real close. Hold on. Get real close so I can everybody smile. All right. Let me see. Here we go. We're all smiling, looking good. And all right. Awesome. So
awesome.
Before you go, Manuel, thank you again. What? Who's yelling here? Tegan, what did you say?
Send me the picture.
Oh, of this. Oh, okay. I'll post it. So, Manuel, thank you so much. I know it was interesting how this all panned out on Twitter. I really appreciate you just reaching out. This has been amazing. So I just appreciate your time and your energy and just I really like what you're doing. It's really neat.
Well, thanks, man. Where are you guys in California?
We're in Riverside. Let's see. It's east of Los Angeles, about an hour.
Okay. I was going to, because I'm coming to Anaheim. I would love to meet, but I'm going to be at ISTE. I don't know if you're going to be there at the technology conference.
Oh, I'd love to go.
In November. Yeah, it'd be cool. So yeah, I'll be, but yeah, that's great. I mean, that's awesome. Yeah, anytime. Like, I would love to do this during school. It's totally fine. I enjoy doing this. I enjoy seeing like different perspectives. Being challenged, so now I got to draw sideways, people.
Well, I'll definitely be tapping into you for next year's class for sure.
Sure. Awesome. Well, you guys take care. Stay safe.
All right. Unmute yourself, you guys, and tell them goodbye.
Bye.
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 Yeah, I know.
All right, dude, I'll see you soon, man. Let me know how else I can help.
Thanks, Manuel. All right, guys, mute yourself real quick. Manuel's going to take off. Thanks again.
Yeah.
Everybody else, mute yourself. And
you guys are very good, yeah.
They're good.
Take care, guys. We'll see you soon.
Bye, Manuel.
Bye-bye.
All right. Thank you, guys. Awesome. Big thumbs up. Did you like that? Yeah, that was really good. I really appreciated that a lot. So Just a couple things real quick before we sign off. We've been on a long time. You guys have been very patient, and I appreciate that. Thank your parents for letting you stay on this long. Please work on your playlist this week. You can, if you need time this weekend, you can keep working on it. I'll send off the weekly feedback just to let your parents know what you've been doing and what you haven't been doing. If you have questions, you know how to message me. If you need to have a private video time, let me know that as well, okay? So we need to wrap this up real quick, Nolan. If you guys can hold your questions, great. But if not, Nolan, what's your quick question?
Can I do extra math for tomorrow? Because I forgot to do it on Monday.
Yes, that's what I was saying. That's you have part of today. You have today and part of tomorrow, okay? And Hayden, you had a question? You need to unmute yourself there, Mr. Hayden. Brito, go ahead and mute yourself. Hayden, can you unmute? It should be down at the bottom. There's be like a little thing that pops up. Hopefully. Let's see here. There we go. I lost you. All right. Did you find it, Hayden, the unmute button? Okay, Tegan, thanks for joining us. Appreciate it. Have fun. Do some swimming for me, too. While Hayden's working on that, Rob left the meeting. Anybody else have a question while we're waiting for Hayden? All right. Bye, Zachary. Thank you for joining us. I appreciate that. Thank you, David. I'm so glad you could join us too. And Aiden A, nice job. I appreciate it. Keep working hard, you guys. Okay, do as much as you can. And the rest of you guys, thank you. Don't forget, some of you do the Lori Z videos, okay? Try and do the Lori Z video. All right, Aiden, put down the toy and you can log out. All right. Malesh, if you have a question, you can type it in. If you, or unless not, you're good. Let's see here. Everyone's saying bye. I can't unmute Hayden, so I can mute him, but I can't unmute him. All right, Connor, you can go. Bye, Malesh. Thanks for joining us. All right.
There.
All right, go for it.
You hear us?
You have a question?
Is it working?
Ah, yes.
What I was going to say is I also have another picture.
Yeah, let me see it.
A picture of a wolf.
Okay, real close. Oh, my gosh, that's cool. Well done. I'm sure he would say, you know, keep practicing, but also color it in. I'd love to see what colors you choose.
Okay.
Nice job. I love it. Did you like the meeting manual?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's pretty cool, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I love it. All right. Well, thanks for sharing. All right, guys, that's it. Have a good Friday, and we'll see you guys next week. You can go ahead and log out. Bye.
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 Bye, Mr. Deaver.
Bye, Violet.
Bye. You like my drawing?
I do. It's very cool. I like the color you chose, too.
I think there will be a lot of gold coins under her.
She's a rich, rich person, huh?
Yeah, she's a queen.
Bye, Alice.
She has emeralds in her crown.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
Okay, I'm leaving.
All right, bye, Violet. Say bye to your family, too.
Bye, family.
Bye, Alice. You can log out, too.
Bye. Right.
Bye, peace, Violet. Peace. All right. Are you still there, Alice, or are you gone? All right, let's see here. All right. There you go. All right. Stop recording.